By mid-March this year, it was reckoned that about 500,000 PCR tests were run on COVID-19 alone. We depend on these tests to make good healthcare decisions, which are now of national importance. But what can we do at Waters to ensure that this goes as well as possible? Well, welcome to my first quick look webcast on how we help to ensure that PCR diagnostics work for virus detection. Briefly, this is how PCR diagnostics work. RNA is extracted from the virus, which has been isolated from the biofluids of an infected patient. Then, a specific gene target is to be amplified. Each test actually requires a pair of primers that bracket the target sequence. A polymerase can then do the amplification, and detection is done by fluorescence. And often to do this, we use a fluorescently labeled oligonucleotide primer. If the gene is present, and so the virus is present, we get a positive result. However, if there's a problem with the primer doesn't bind to the gene and we get no amplification and we get no detection. And in these cases, if it was an infected patient, we get a false negative result. So how can we tell if the primers are good? Well, we would do this by measuring the primer length by UPLC, and we would do it with the UPLC system shown here, which is the Acuity H class. And this is what the UPLC chromatogram of oligonucleotides look like. This is actually a standard of oligonucleotides between 15 and 35 bases long. Usually it'll take about 10 minutes to get a result like this. And this is great because the COVID-19 primers are typically 19 to 26 bases long. Now getting a result like this actually requires the correct approach. We use bridged ethyl hydride C18 or BEHC18 columns for this analysis because of their good separation and their speed and being true sub 2 micron UPLC particles, but also probably more importantly because of their stability in the conditions used in this analysis, which is typically a high pH and a high temperature, which many other column chemistries just simply can't handle. The result shown before was using these standards, and these are used to validate the equipment before the experiment is run, and they are also used to help measure the length of the oligonucleotides during the experiment. But more importantly, every column that ships for this purpose has been pre-validated using the standards as well, and that way we can ensure that there are fit for purpose components to carry out this analysis. Okay, so after UPLC separation, we know that the length is right, but what else can go wrong in the manufacture of the primers? Well, if the primers have been chemically modified or simply the wrong bases have been added, then we would see a change in molecular weight. And we would measure the molecular weight using mass spectrometry. And this is how we would do this, using a compliant-ready simplified mass spectrometer in what we would call the BioAccord system, which is a very small mass spectrometer. It's about the size of an LC system. And this is the mass spectrum of an oligonucleotide. And you can see it's not easy to interpret because it has multiple charge states. What we want to be able to do is simplify all these charge states into a mass. And we do this by a process called deconvolution. Now, don't worry too much about deconvolution because most of this is handled automatically on board by the instrument system. In the method setup for the mass spectrometer, we define the expected molecular weight of the primers that we're manufacturing. And we work this out from the intended sequence for the primers. In this case, we've just put in the molecular weight of the sequences that we know are in the standards. Then we can control, set up the processing parameters, including the parameters for deconvolution. And even amongst the few settings that there are, we can tell the instrument that we're looking at oligonucleotides so that it can automatically optimize the processing for them. Once the data is acquired, we have three very simple views that tell us how the experiment has gone. First of all, we have the measured masses, which are being compared to the expected masses. You can see here that we're getting about 4.7 ppm mass accuracy. So this is a high mass accuracy machine. The industry standard for this sort of analysis is about 10 ppm. So this comes well within what we would hope for. We get a window that shows us the retention times, which we discussed earlier, show the oligonucleotide length. And we also get a deconvoluted mass spectrum of everything that was in that run. And you can see there where it's been labeled by the expected masses that we put in and the identities that we assigned. So everything that we expected to see shows up in green. And that is simply how we do it, using our small, accurate mass MS system, BioCord, that provides simplified, compliant, ready results. So this gives us great confidence that the primers that are being used in diagnostics are good and then they're correct. And so we can go on and give accurate results and diagnose the sick from the healthy and help make good healthcare decisions. Now, this is one of our many oligonucleotide solutions which are required at different levels of analysis. If you want to know more about this, you can download the whole application solution from waters.com/oligos.